What's going on, guys? All right, we have a banded body weight workout today. So I'm going to be using a variety of mini bands and pull-up assist bands. You can just use one of each if you have it. Well, I will say on the mini bands, because we're going to do some upper body with a mini band and lower body. So you may want a lighter band for upper body versus lower body if you have that. As far as the pull-up assist bands, if you just have one, that's fine. I have several with different resistances, so I am going to use those according to whatever the movement is that I'm going to do. But this is a great workout for travel. If you're going somewhere that you don't have any equipment or you're unsure of, because you can just take those bands and take no room in your suitcase. So this is a really good workout, or this could be an active recovery type day. I would probably cut back on some of the reps and sets if it was an active recovery day. But this is stuff that you could do with light bands, resistance, just to get the blood pumping to help you recover as well. So this is a really good versatile type workout to do. All right, so we are going to start with your mini band. And we're going to start with it on the ankles. I'm using my slingshot because it's super heavy resistance. So I want a pretty decent workout today, nothing too much of a Tuesday. This is not an active recovery day for me, but this is a day I'm using it to move and stimulate muscle growth and things like that, but not doing weights because my deflator veins is lit up today. And to be honest, I am so sore from the Saturday workout. This is Monday, June 13th, and June 15th. And I am so lit up from the outdoor Saturday workout that we did. So I'm using this to move, get loose, but still stimulate muscle growth, burn some good calories as well. So let me get this going and we'll get going. The other beauty of a band workout is you don't really have to warm up or cool down because we're not pushing heavy weight. And you can just get moving, which again makes this a short and sweet workout to get done. All right, so let's start with lateral steps. Okay, toes are straight ahead, core's engaged, slight hinge in those hips, and take a big step or as big as you can with your band to the side. Make sure I drive with that whole foot, get the heel on the floor. I'm not rotating and pulling with that toe. All right, for 30, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, we're going to do diagonal step back. So with this, I'm not just stepping my foot back. I'm squeezing my glute, contracting, and that glute contraction or hip extension will pull the foot back. So it's not a big range of motion, all right? So I want you to think about squeezing the glute to pull the foot back, not just stepping. Like right there, I'm stepping, zero glute activation. Right here, I squeeze the glute and it pulls me back. Pull, okay? So I'm kind of doing somewhat of a hip hike a little bit when I'm squeezing that glute. All right, so we have 30 of these. Slight hinge in those hips, knees are soft, squeeze the glute and step. 1, squeeze, 2, think about what you're working. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, squeeze it, 2, don't let it go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9. Squeeze 8, 7, 6. Should be feeling this. 5, come on. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay, I'm going to switch out bands for the next one. Still need a thick, heavy mini band. That one's just too thick for me for this next movement. So the band is going to go around the feet like this, okay? And we're going to squat with the knee raised. So we're going to hit those hip flexors, all right? Again, we have 30 of these guys. So cores are nice and tight. Weights in the heels. Here we go. squats and pull. One, two, three, four, five. Keeping that core engaged. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Really feeling those glutes. Nine and ten. Ten more. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Woo! All right, put it back above the ankles. So now we're going to squat with a lateral raise. Okay, we take a drink. All right, so we are going to squat, squeeze up. Squat, squeeze up. Again, squeezing from here. Don't just kick that leg out. Think about what we're working. Working the outside of those hips, our abductors, okay? This is a lot of people really need to work on strengthening the outside here so that your knees don't collapse when you squat or lunge or deadlift, things like that. Or if you're having knee pain when you lunge or squat, one, check your form first to make sure it's right. But if you do it in front of a mirror and you notice that knee starts to come in, really need to work on strengthening the outside of those hips to even out the muscle groups, because one, you're in a bad muscle pattern. Two, you started to strengthen this inside the middle quad here, your quad's four muscles here, and it's taking over and doing the majority of the work. So you need to even it out, okay? All right, here we go for 30. Ready, core tight, squat, squeeze. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, core tight, 4, in the heels, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! All right, back to the top. So, when we're doing banded work, because it is resistance, it's just not like using heavy weights, so we're increasing our reps and sets to give us that stimulus. So we have to go a little bit more reps to continue to stimulate muscle growth. Woo! Okay, here we go. Lateral steps. So higher reps, so that's what we're going to do. All right, shoulders back. Chest is high. We're going to burn these glutes up today. Woo! And this is really good. Here we go for 30 steps. One, really good strengthening of the hips and the knees and the ankles, and I encourage you to go barefoot. When we wear shoes, shoes do a lot of compensating for us and don't give us feedback. Especially, a lot of people have really limited ankle mobility. And so if you can work barefoot to work on those ankles, it will help you with your squats, your lunges, things like that. This is 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, our diagonal step backs. Remember, squeeze the glute to step back. So, shoulders back, slide into the hips, core is embraced. Ready, squeeze and step. 1, 2. So what you have to think about, guys, 3, 4, is knee pain is not from the knee. It comes from your hips or your ankles being off, okay? Your knee and your elbow are what we call floating joints, right? They're in the middle. So something has to be off at one of the distal ends, your shoulder, wrist, or hip, or ankle, for it to start to show itself in your knee, right? So if it's off in your hip, it's going to show itself in the next joint, which is your knee. If it's off in the ankle, it's going to show itself in the next joint, which is your knee. So that's why this kind of stuff is really good for pelvic alignment. That's 20. We've got 10, 9, 8, squeeze that glute, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, switch your bands out, going back to those squats. That's why it's really good to do this type of work and pay attention to where you're off, or look at your form in the mirror and try and adjust and fix what's wrong. Is it in the hips or the ankle? And a lot of people, it's the ankle. They have really limited ankle mobility because you spend all day in your shoes, and your shoes brace your ankle and keep you from firing all these little muscles that are in your toes and your ankle and getting them stronger. So, all right, here we go. Squat with a knee raise, shoulders back, core embrace. Here we go. Squat and pull. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, above those ankles, grab a quick drink, grab a squat, lateral raise, squat, lateral raise, squat, and raise again. Thinking about what we're working, squeeze from up hips, don't just kick that knee up there. Okay, shoulders back, chest up, core brace, here we go. Squat and squeeze, 2, and 1. Woo-wee. All right, guys, back to the top. One more time through. Lateral steps. Okay, shoulders back and down. Abs in tight, right hinge in those hips. Knees are soft, toes straight ahead. Reach with the whole foot, not the toes. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Four, we're there. 3, come on. 2, and 1. Woo, shake it out for a second. All right, diagonal setback. Squeeze the glute to pull the foot back. All right, mind in the muscle. Shoulders back and down, core is brace, hinge at the hips, knees are soft. Here we go, squeeze the glute and step. 1, 2, squeeze it. 3, 4, 5, keeping that core brace. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, squeeze, 3, come on, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, we got it, come on, squeeze, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay, we're going to replace our squats this time with sit-ups. So, take your, your mini band. You're going to put it above the knees. All right, so I am going to hold tension on those thighs through my whole sit-up so they never come in and collapse. Squeeze out, keeping my feet flat on the floor. Don't roll out on the outside of your heels, okay? Keep those knees out when you come into your sit-up, all right? We have 20. Ready? And up. 1, 2, remember when I lower with my sit-up. 3, pushing vertebrae by vertebrae down. 4, keep those knees out. Come on. 5, it should burn like fire. 6, it's an isometric contraction on those hips. 7, 8, 9, 10, you got 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, come on, 6, push, 5, think about what we're doing, 4, 3, 2, and 1, good. All right, bring that band down. We have bicycles. So engaging that back, pressing it firmly into the floor, bracing the core, band around those feet, shoulders are up, chin is out of the chest, and we're gonna press right here for 20, okay? All right, so activate, back and floor, chin up, chest or shoulders off the floor, ready? Here we go, press long and low. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. All right. Woo, round one is done. Round two. So we have, you can elevate this. I'm going to use my bench to do it. You can keep it on the floor, okay? You can use weights to elevate. You can put your heels up on your weights to get you up, to give you a little bit more range of motion, all right? So, I'm gonna go heels elevated on my box, band above the knees. We're gonna start with glute bridges. So again, keeping distance on the, or between the knees, on those hips, all right? Knees over hips. Heels down, toes up. Nice tension the whole time on those legs. Do not let them collapse at all. Keep them out. Okay, so we have 30 of these. Ready? And up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Press on that band. Squeeze tight at the top. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 1, 2, 3, keep those knees out, come on, 4, squeeze, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, there's 20, we got 10 more, press, come on, 10, 9, 8, woo, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! All right, so we have heel elevated, abductors. Heels down. We're going to come up, and we're going to pull out for 30, keeping those hips high for all 30 reps. All right, here we go. Nice tension on that band. Drive those knees apart. Raise it up, and give me a little more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 45 from my hips, okay? Pull the ankles at a 45 from the knee right here, keeping my feet together. I'm going to lay back and put my shoulders square to the floor like this, so I have my torso rotated. All right, keeping my feet together, I'm going to drive that knee up, squeezing from the outside hip. Okay, think about pulling from here versus just driving that knee up, all right? So we got 30 on each side. Ready? Here we go. Up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! Okay, roll it over. Knees at the 45, ankles at the 45. Shoulders are flat to the floor. Ready? Squeeze up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 10, 9, 8, 7. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. All right, shake it out for a second. We got to repeat. Repeat, repeat. Whew. Okay, my glutes are lit up. All right. Whew. All right, here we go. Glute bridges. Nice distance between those knees, so I've got constant tension or constant glute activation down here, all the way from the bottom to the top of the movement. Horse brace at the top. Make sure our chin is in our chest. We are not extending or flexing that neck up like that. Okay, keep your chin in your chest just like when you do a hip thrust or a deadlift. All right, here we go. Tension on that band. Ready and drive. 1, 2, 3, keep pushing against that band. 4, 5, fight through it. Come on. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3. Come on. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Push on that band. 9. Come on. 20. You got 10, squeeze, 9, 8, come on, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, come on, 2, 1. Woo! Oh, let them rest for a second. We got those glute isolation abductors. Woo! All right, we got this. So, tension on that band. We're going to come up, and we're going to push and give even more tension on that band for 30. All right, bring it up. Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hips up. 9. Come on. 10. Fight it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. You got it. 10. Come on. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! Oh, Lord. All right, clamshells. Clamshells. Feet together. Knees at the 45. Ankles at the 45 from the knee. Rotated. Shoulders flat. Ready? And up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, woo, 7, 8, 9, 20. Oh man, come on. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, Movements is important, and we should do it, or you should be doing it regular than we do, but I just wanted to explain that why. All right, so we have 90-90 in the shoulders. So we are going to external rotate, internal, external, internal. All right, so we're hitting it in all four, or both movements in both planes, four movements. So we have 15 of these. So elbows up, ready, out, over, up, and in. That's one. Out, over, up, two. Out, over, up, three. Out, over, up, four. Out, over, up, five. Out, over, up, six. Out, over, up, seven. Out, over, up, eight. Out, over, up, nine. Out, over, up, 10. Out, over, up, 11. Out, over, up, 12. Out, over, up, 13. Out, over, up, 14. Out, over, up, and 15. All right, movement two is two movements as well. So we're gonna work our back in two directions. So we have a row like this, which is a pull back and a pull down. Okay, because your scapula, again, works in two planes, front to back, up and down. So we're gonna hit them both. So you have out like this, row, elbows high and wide, bring it up, pull down, and release. Back and down, okay? All right, so that, we have 15 of these as well. All right, so starting here, gonna come up, row, release, up, one, row, two, and three. Think about what we're working. Scapula's back, scapula's down. Four, back, and down. This one gets me good. Five, pull, six, seven. Woo. Up. Pull. Eight. Nine. Ten. That's five. Up. Pull. Four. Three. Woo. Pull. One more. Up. Pull. And pull. Woo. All right. 15. All right. Last. Bicep curl to an overhead press. This is where you're going to need your pull-up band. So we're going to step on our band. You're going to have to maybe play with it a couple reps to get your tension right. So I'm going to hold down on my band because I want resistance with my bicep curl and then into my overhead press. Okay? So I'm holding hammer grip. You could, if you wanted to, turn it and do palms up, bicep curl, if you wanted, like that as well. Actually, I think I'm going to do that. That's less tension on my decorative band. It feels better. So you can go hammer grip, palms up, you pick, whatever works for you. Increase your tension by how far apart your feet are, or get you a thicker band. All right, you ready? Here we go. And up. Curl and press and down. One. Curl, press, two. Keeping that core tight. Don't arch those back at the top. Pressing that band over. Three. Up. Four. Look back at it. Five. Come on. Six. Up. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Woo. All right, shake it out for a second, guys. We'll go back to the top and do it again. Yeah. still burning a decent amount of calories for today. Keeping heart rate perfect. Haven't gone over 130 beats yet. I'm at 244 calories, 33 minutes in. So, what is that, about, six, seven calories per 10 minutes? No, per minute. Oh, forgive me, guys. It's a Monday. And I've been up since 4:45 with my child this morning. So, all right. Here we go. Back to the top. Working that rotator cuff. All right. Here we go. Elbows up. Core brace. Let's go. Out. Over. Up. And in. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, 5, 4, 3, keep those elbows up, 2, and 1, woo, alright, hit the shoulder blades, our row to our pull down, alright, oh, my shoulders are already feeling it, okay, shoulders back and down, core brace. Here we go. Raise up. Big pull down. One. Up. Pull. And down. Two. Up. Pull. Three. Up. Four. Up. Five. Up. And six. Pull. Pull down. Seven. Ooh. Up. Pull. Eight. Up. Pull. Nine. Pull. And ten. Woo. Pull. Five. Pull. Four. Pull. Three. Pull. Two. Woo. One more. Up. Pull. And pull. Good. All right, grab that big red band or whatever band you're using. Curl over and presses. The reason we do a curl over, I mean, it works a lot of muscles, but the reason I love a curl overhead press is it's incredibly functional. This transfers to so many things. Picking something up off of a shelf, putting it up high, picking something off high, bringing it down low. This is a really, really good, one of the best functional exercises, I guess, like next to a squat or something like that, because you're doing this type of movement all day long. All right, here we go. Shoulders back. Ready? Palm up or hammer grip, your pick. One, depending upon your grip, it will hit your shoulders a little bit different. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, five more. Five, four, three, two, and one. Good. All right, moving on. So we're going to do a couple compound movements. And then a little bit of body weight, and we're out. So we're going to do a reverse lunge to a row. We're going to hit that back again. So you need your mini band around your wrist. And what we're going to do is reverse lunge and row, just like that, working them both. And we have 20 of these, 20 of these. Oh, my shoulders. Shoulders are so sore from this. This is just lighting them up from the workout, again, that we did on Saturday. It's a ridiculous amount of push-ups, and I'm just super sore. All right, so alternating legs, shoulders back and down. As we step, we row. We make it a compound movement. All right, you ready? Here we go, step in row. One, two, Keeping those double time. One, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo, throw that down. All right, squat thruster, squat thruster. You need your big pull-up band. All right, so squat thruster. Bring your band up to shoulder height, elbows inside the band. I want you to squat and thrust, just like we would with dumbbells. All right, we have 15 of these. Weights in the heels, shoulders back and down, core is braced. Let's go. Squat, one. Make sure you don't arch the back. Two, squeeze the glute. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, five, four, three, two, and one. Woo! All right, so now we're gonna do a tall kneel to stand. I'm gonna use a heavier band for this one. And the difference between this and a reverse lunge is we pause. We stop at the bottom so that we're pressing up. So I'm gonna take my band, I'm gonna put it around my foot and over this shoulder like this, okay? And I'm gonna come back into tall kneel. So every time I stop and pause at the bottom and I drive up through that leg, pause, drive up through that leg, okay? So I'm not using the momentum from the lunge to help me come up, all right? So right here, we're gonna do 15 on each leg. Stay up nice and tall, core is braced, push. One, two, three, four, all the work's in this leg right here. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, five, four, three, two, one. Good. So 15 on the other leg. Now, if you needed to shorten this workout, this is probably going to be, 45, 46, 47 minute long workout. If you need to shorten it up, just take some sets off. Okay, up one, two, shorten the reps, three, four, make sure you're pushing through this front leg, five, pausing at the bottom, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. All right, some body weight stuff to finish it out. So we have 50 walking narrow to wide squats. So it's going to look like this. So I'm going to start narrow, wide, bring it in, narrow, wide, okay? Make sure you don't step and squat at the same time. Plant it, then squat, so we don't have you shifting to one side or the other when you squat. All right, each squat counts as one. We got 50. Ready? Here we go. Narrow, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 6. Good. All right. 50 forward lunges. 50 forward lunges. All right. Shoulders back, chest high. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 1, 2, 3, I think that was just 10, yeah. 4, wishful thinking, right? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's 20. 2, 1 more. Good. Alright, last 50, guys, and we're out. Sumo squats. Nice and wide. Toes out at the 45. Shoulders stacked over hips. Push out, squeezing those glutes. Don't let those knees flex. So when I push out, keeping those glutes tight, let those knees do not fold forward. Okay? Alright, 450. Let's go. Squeeze tight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, you got it. 8, take a mind form. 9, 10. Squeeze tight. 1, 2, 3. Squeeze those glutes back. Don't let those knees collapse. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 10, 9, 8, 5. You got it. Come on. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! All right, guys, that's it. So that was 48 minutes of work. Like I said, if, you know, you're in a rush, traveling, hotel, something like that in the morning, traveling for work, need something quick, just cut a set off of each one or drop your reps to 20. Whatever works for your time frame, but it's a nice full body workout. Burn close to 400 calories in 48 minutes of that, which is not about the calorie burn. I'm just trying to give you a reference about it. But this is excellent, excellent work. Even though you're not pushing heavy weight, you're still stimulating muscle by the amount of reps that we're using and sets that we're using for this. And then it's good to stimulate your muscles with a different stimulus of sorts every once in a while. Now, could you do this every day and continue to get results? No, it should just be peppered in amongst your weights like this. But it's a really good complement to doing weight training. So, especially if you're having any kind of knee, back, hip pain, something like this, doing this once a week will greatly improve that for you. So, have a good day, enjoy it, and I'll see you guys on the next one.